All right, welcome back inside our Vancouver Proactive Studios. And joining us now from our Toronto studio is Joseph Lusardi. He's the CEO of Curaleaf. And Joseph, it's great to meet you. How are you?
Good. Thanks for having me.
Yeah, thanks very much. Tell us a little bit about Curaleaf. How long have you guys been around?
Sure. Curaleaf's been around since 2010. We are the biggest multi-state operator in the United States. Our footprint spans from Maine all the way to Florida on the East Coast, and we also operate in California, Nevada, Oregon, and Arizona. Our Curaleaf CBD brand is available in 47 states across the country, and we think that the U.S. market shows tremendous promise for 19, and we're proud to be a leader of the U.S. cannabis industry.
Yeah, give us an idea about some of the products that you have. There's the hemp-based products, CBDs, that kind of stuff?
We do. Well, we really started in regulated cannabis markets. And so we have over 600 SKUs of products, including THC and CBD formulated products in those markets. But last year, we also launched a national CBD line. And that's a 15 SKU product line that's comprised of lotions, patches, infused oils, and it will also include skincare products in Q2. So we're really excited about that line of products. The farm bill at the end of last year descheduled hemp. So we're pretty excited about the growth prospects for that product in 19 and 20.
Yeah, let's talk a little bit about that, because I think you bring on a really great point in the fact that up until that particular point, especially with the gels, the topicals, the skin creams, I mean, I think we're only scratching the surface of what people are going to be able to buy in the near future.
We agree. If you look at the estimates of the market, their predictions, it could grow to as much as $22 billion in 3 years. So there's going to be a tremendous amount of consumer demand for CBD products and really all form factors. I think that the topicals and the lotions and the infused oils are the first iteration. But I think you'll see a very robust product set being offered across the country that includes CBD and some of the other minor cannabinoids as well, CBG and other products that come out of the hemp plant.
You recently had someone take a stake out of your company, and that being BlackRock, which is a pretty good, considering there hasn't been a lot of money being spread around. You're getting a good substantial part of it from BlackRock. Tell us about the relationship with them.
Well, we did a public offering in the fall of last year, and we raised $400 million from 100 institutions around the globe. So what I would say about our offering and our shareholder base in general, it's a very sophisticated investor base and people that understand the long-term value creation that Curaleaf will create for shareholders. And so, we're proud to have all those institutions as shareholders.
You recently made an acquisition of a company called Eureka. Tell us about Eureka and what you found so fascinating about them.
Sure. We made an acquisition in California. I think that, we started in regulated East Coast markets with limited license and the best economic profile. But it's clear that California is the biggest, consumer market for cannabis in the U.S. And if you're going to create a national brand, you have to be in Canada ultimately. And so we acquired a platform in California. It's really the beginning of our California strategy. It's a low-cost, high-quality farm in Salinas. And we think it's a platform where we can build manufacturing and retail off of.
And do you see, obviously, you mentioned California is a big market. What about Canada as well? Do you see that as a place that you would head to also and maybe outside of North America?
We're going to be focused on the U.S. for the foreseeable future. It is the biggest, most developed market for cannabis in the world, and we think it has the best growth prospects. So it's not to say Canada won't be a great market, but we have enough to do in our own home soil, and we're going to stay really focused on our domestic market for the foreseeable future.
Okay. And last question, let's talk about from shareholder base, what can they expect from the company over the next year?
I think we'll continue to build on our industry leading, operational platform. We'll continue to create a national brand through Curaleaf. And I think that, we're really focused on executing on our core business and creating a lot of value for shareholders.
Well, it's fascinating to learn a little bit more about the company. Thanks so much for the time. Great to talk to you and learn more about it.
Yeah, thanks for having me.
All right, it's Joseph Lusardi. He's the CEO of Curaleaf.